Thanks for watching these videos filled with unusual facts. Browse through our catalog of videos to make sure you haven't missed any. Subscribe so you never miss a single video again. Like this video if you learned something new. Comment below because we want to hear from you. 25 jaw-dropping facts about World War II. Due to the nature of state secrets and different methods of education across the globe, there were some stories you may not have heard. Here we are to let you know about some of those fascinating facts of war alongside stunning photographs. Number 25, Christchurch Greyfriars, London, UK. Built in 1687 to replace another church that had burned down in the Great Fire of London 21 years prior, Christchurch Greyfriars was designed by legendary architect Sir Christopher Wren. When the Second World War rolled around, German Luftwaffe planes relentlessly bombarded the British capital with bombs during their Blitzkrieg raids, and one of the victims of these bombings was the Christchurch Greyfriars. Post-war, it was decided that the structure would not be rebuilt, but it did become a Grade 1 listed building in 1950, meaning it must remain untouched by development. Now a beautiful rose garden that mimics the church's former layout, it has become a place of calm serenity within the bustling crowds of the metropolis. Number 24, an ill-fated attempt to escape the infamous Colditz Castle. Several British prisoners of war tried to tunnel out, but only ended up as far as the German officer's wine cellar. As a form of retribution, the POWs drank all the wine and then refilled the bottles with their own urine, placing them back on the shelves. 23. Pogroms. As Nazis invaded countries across Europe, collaborators would often carry out atrocities against the Jewish populations there. These involved beatings, humiliation, violent raids, massacres and executions, and later became known as pogroms. The picture is of a Ukrainian woman left in the city of Lviv, stripped and trying to cover herself as she is publicly shamed. 22. Eye for a kill. Russian sniper Lyudmila Pavlichenko, defending Sevastopol, Crimea, from Nazi invasion. By the end of the war, she had killed a confirmed 309 Germans, making her the most successful female sniper in history. Women across the globe were embroiled in the conflict alongside men, and the fact that women had to work in factories whilst men were gone or fighting alongside men led to greater women's liberation across the globe post-war. 21. Cunning cards. One American playing card company issued a pack of cards to be sent to POWs being held in Germany. These cards could then be soaked and had escape routes printed on them that would be revealed by the water. Number 20. For the Motherland. Soviet guerrillas prepare themselves to come face to face with Nazi invaders as they train in Russia. With many Soviet men fighting on fronts across Europe and the Nazis approaching the Soviet Union, women often joined guerrilla movements so they could fight the invaders entering their homeland. Number 19. Living the high life. The British had a very novel way of extracting information from their German prisoners and would often let the higher-ranking officials live in relative luxury so that they felt more comfortable. Unbeknownst to them, they were being listened to at all times, and their secrets were often discovered as they felt so relaxed they could talk about them openly. Number 18. Hitler visits Paris in 1941, shortly after the invasion. The Nazis' ruthless invasion of France in 1940 was perhaps Hitler's greatest achievement, and while France was a sworn enemy, Hitler made no secret of his love for the City of Lights, and is reported to have said that visiting the city shortly after the invasion was the greatest and finest moment of my life. With that being said, the Führer told Albert Speer, shortly after his poignant photo was taken, "Berlin must be far more beautiful. When we are finished in Berlin, Paris will only be a shadow." Number 17. War Child. London was blitzed heavily in the war, and the resulting damage was catastrophic for its social and economic climate. However, as this photo depicts, infants were not exempt from the damages. 16. Meeting the Führer. Captain Hannah Reich was a German aviatrix who developed airplane armament instruments during World War II. Because of this, she was awarded the Iron Cross Second Class at the Reich Chancellery in Berlin, Germany in 1941 of April. Here she is, shaking hands with Hitler, as Hermann Göring looks on. Number 15. Maquis Warrior. The little-known Maquis fighters fought in the Italian Alps against German and Italian fascists since 1927. 14. The Six Faces of Death. In the bloody Sunday Massacre of 1939, German officials in the Polish city of Bydgoszcz decided to kill over 14% of the entire city's population in response to a fight that broke out between German sabotages and members of the Polish army. And as this haunting photo illustrates, the last moments of a life before death are ones that encompass a range of human emotions. Number 13. St. Michael's Old Cathedral, Coventry, UK. Coventry was at the heart of Britain's industry during World War II, and so the Luftwaffe targeted it heavily with bombings and attacks. One of the tragic losses of the city was St. Michael's Cathedral, which was left gutted after the vicious attacks. Now just a husk of its former self, the Gothic cathedral from the 15th century stands next to its far more recent counterpart, linking the modern city to its troubled past. Number 12. The former Prefectural Industrial Promotional Hall, Hiroshima, Japan. Designed by Czech architect Jan Letzel and constructed in 1915, the former Prefectural Industrial Promotion Hall, now often referred to as the A-bomb Dome, was supposed to echo European architecture and was used to hold events and exhibitions. When America dropped its first atomic bomb on Hiroshima, the building was only 160 meters away from the center of the blast, meaning that all inside died. Due to the nature of the nuclear weapon, the air around the building was burned up, and so it did not collapse, despite being so close to the explosion. Now it has become an even more important monument, as it sits inside Japan's Peace Park and represents a desire for world peace. Preserved in its current state as a reminder of the destruction humanity can bring upon itself. Number 11. Body Standards. The Hitler Youth prized athleticism and conformity, and members were often subject to inspections. The female wing of this was called the League of German Girls and included a faith and beauty society, which welcomed young women aged 17 to 21. Number 10, the dichotomy of war. Captured during the moments before American soldiers invaded Normandy in 1944, the significance of the photo lies less in its information and more from its picture. One only has to see the bright colored flowers overlooking human life as a symbol that war's brutality goes against everything the world was intended for. Number 9. The impact on wildlife. A lone reindeer in Russia stands still as hawker hurricanes bombed nearby fields. Many forget the impact war has on nature as well as human beings, a truth timely captured by this juxtaposition photograph as hawker hurricanes bombed a hillside in Murmansk, Russia. Hawker hurricanes bombed a hillside in Murmansk, Russia, while a shell-shocked reindeer looked on. Number 8. The Greek Resistance won Greek POWs their freedom. When the Italian armed tried to invade Greece, the Resistance was sturdy and hard-fought, so much so that the Germans had to be called in for their support. So impressed was he by such shows of courage and cunning that Hitler ordered Greek POWs be allowed to return home, albeit now being under German-Italian occupation. Number 7. Flying Tigers. Known as the Flying Tigers, American forces enlisted the help of many trained Chinese pilots during their war effort. Pictured flying over China in 1942 by pilot Robert T. Smith, this stunning photograph captures the iconic nosework that came to characterize the American-manufactured Curtiss P-40 Warhawk planes. Number 6. Inside Hitler's Bunker. This photo captures the ruins of Hitler's bunker shortly after his suicide. Taken shortly after the end of World War II and was one of the first to capture the bunker's interior, where it is believed the Nazi leader Adolf Hitler spent his final weeks before committing suicide. Number 5. Never giving up. Franz von Wehra was a German POW who was desperate to get back to the action. The fighter pilot's attempts to escape were so often that he was eventually transferred from Britain to Canada to stop him getting back to the war. But this didn't help. Getting away from his Canadian prison, he went through South America to Spain and then Germany to once again get back to combat. He was the only Western-held POW to return to action during the conflict. Number 4. Code of Honor. Some German prisoners who were kept at American internment camps were quite often let out on an honor system. When some of them did get back to their native land and told of the decent treatment they received, the Nazi forces started to treat their POWs a little better as well. Number 3. Away from the glamours of Hollywood. Even movie stars weren't immune from helping out in the war effort, and in this picture, Ida Lupino works as a lieutenant in the Women's Ambulance and Defense Corps as a telephone switchboard is put in her home in Brentwood, California on July 3, 1942. The glamorous Hollywood actress, Veronica Lake, demonstrates the dangers of wearing your hair long whilst working in factories for the war effort in a picture taken on November 9, 1943. Just a couple facts left about World War II. Here's number 2. Shipping out. These members of the Women's Army Corps, WAC, pose for a photograph at Camp Shanks in New York just before shipping out on February 2, 1945. These women were the first contingent of Black American WACs to go overseas during World War II. And finally, number 1, a returning soldier kisses a nurse in New York's Times Square, 1945. When American Navy soldiers returned from battle in August of 1945 to celebrate VJ Day, one sailor took it upon himself to kiss a nearby nurse. Thanks for watching this video filled with unusual facts today about World War II. Tomorrow could be about vinegar. You'll have to subscribe so you never miss a single video. Like this video if you learned something new, if you enjoyed the dramatic pictures.